Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with History, Standard 7. Topic is Chapter 2, that is the discussion of question and answers and all the fill in the blanks and whatever given related to the chapter. Students, in this slide you'll see whatever I have marked, and that is page number 10 of your history book. You can see I have marked some important lines with the pencil. So you are also asked to underline whatever is given, 3-4 pages whatever is given in this chapter I have underlined. So you have to mark according to the question answer. And in the next two slides, that is the remaining two slides, last two slides, I have discussed all the question answers. So you have to mark it, and according to that only you are going to write it in your notebooks along with the questions. In this slide, we'll discuss all the fill in the blanks. So in number 1, you can see of your page number 15. So Emperor Constantine granted special privileges to Christians. Yes, we have already done in the very beginning of this chapter that he did so by granting Christians freedom to worship. Then he gave important jobs and many more things like that. In number 2, we see Dash was a system of granting land on condition of service. It is feudalism. Then the third is Dash was the capital of Eastern Roman Empire. It is Byzantine. Then fourth is Dash were holy wars that were fought between the Christians and the Turks, that are Crusades. And fifth is Dash served at the centers of religious and secular learning. The answer is monasteries. Now come to B part. The words in gray are incorrect and you have to correct them. Saint John spread Christianity in Roman Empire. Do you think Saint John? No, it's wrong. It will be Saint Paul. So only the answer you need to write. Change the part which is given in gray because it is incorrect. You have to correct and write them in these blanks. I hope everyone has done it. So you can match all the answers with the answers given in this slide. Students, before starting with this slide, just let me remind you that whatever is given in page number 15, that is new words and timelines. So these all things you have to remember or memorize it nicely, because any question, internal question, can be given based on this, and the quick quiz and whatever blocks are given in your book, you have to be very thorough with your chapter. Now coming to this slide, we see that number 3, Emperor Theodosius was the first Roman ruler to embrace Christianity. No, it is false. So it will be Emperor Constantine. Visigoth and the second tribe, it's given over there. So that second tribe is the spelling whatever is they have written, that won't be. It will be Ostrogoths, or you can choose other also and you can write the other one. But this part is wrong, so second part you need to change. Then you come to the Byzantine Empire had able rulers such as Charlemagne. No, it's Justinian I. So monks live in convents. No, the nuns used to live in convents. Monks used to live in monasteries. Then number C part, you can see give one word answer that you need to give. The answers like who encouraged non-Jews to embrace Christianity. Now children, don't be confused over here. Here it is written non-Jews to embrace Christianity, and here it is written first Roman ruler to embrace Christianity. So in the first page, if you have any doubt, you can go through to the first page, because through the first page, if you go through, you can understand the difference between these two. What did the Roman call the invading Germanic tribes? Of course, they called barbarians. And who built Hagia Sophia? The spell is Hagia Sophia, so Justinian I. And who attacked the Byzantine Empire in 1453? The Ottoman Turk. And the Pope who urged Christians to go on a crusade? Pope Urban II. Now coming to the give reason for the following part, children. In number 1, you can see Emperor Constantine shifted the capital in 330 CE. Why he shifted? Because the Roman Empire had become too big to be administered efficiently. That you need to write in this give reason. And the second D2, that is 8 crusades were fought in the medieval period. You have to write about that. So you can see in page number 13, it is given over there. I have marked why 8 crusades were fought. What was the reason? Because the victory of the Turks over the Byzantine Empire led many Christians to believe that their religion was under threat. Means they were quite scared of that, like that whatever they have will be going to or going in the hands of the Turks. That's why they were in threat. So they did not want that. So this is the reason why Pope Urban urged them to go on the holy war, which is also known as crusades. Okay, and 8 were fought, and still they were unable to recapture Jerusalem. Now you come to number E part, that is answer these questions. How did Emperor Constantine help to spread Christianity? That you will get in page number 10. Children, if you see the first part, first 4 points I have marked in the very first page of this chapter. That is E1, I have written over there. So all the 4 points you need to write. And then coming to E2, you see discuss the causes for the decline of the ancient Roman Empire. And along with that, one more is there, that is what was the impact of the barbarian invasion. So these 2 questions are in the same question. So what you have to do is change the paragraph while writing, children. Otherwise it will be very problematic to identify whether you have written 1 or you have written 2. So it is better you write it paragraph wise, changing the paragraph. So you can see in page number 11, it's written over there giving E2, that is the first part, and E2 second part. You can see I have given brackets also. So there were many causes for the decline of empire, such as corrupt rulers, frequent outbreaks of civil war, that you can write. Then the main cause for the decline was attack by Germanic tribes, that Visigoths, Ostrogoths, that you need to write till there. And now come to the second part, that is the impact of barbarian invasion. You'll change the paragraph and you'll write the 3 points as I have marked and underlined till there you have to write. So the first one, the invasion weakened the authority of the Roman rulers. Second, the trade declined due to violent political conditions. Third, the most important impact of this invasion was the rise and spread of feudalism. So here we come to the end of E2, and now we will see E3, what is feudalism and who were the serfs. So feudalism, you children, you will get in page number 15, where I have marked in new words. There you can get the definition. So E3, that first part you can write from there. And then the second part, who were the serfs, you have to come into page number 12 for that. And you can see over there I have marked in page number 12. The down part, the serfs occupied the lowest rung among the peasants. And then you start from, after giving full stop, serfs were bonded labor and led miserable lives. I have written there E3 second part. Coming to the E4 question, the crusades left a lasting impact on Europe. Now you have to prove this by 2 points, or explain this statement writing any 2 points, that is E4 number. You will get in page number 13 and then continuation in page number 14. So 2 points you need to write. E4 I have written and marked. First point, you can write down whatever I have marked and underlined. The crusades increased the Pope's authority among Christians. People looked upon the Pope as their guide and leader. And then coming to the next page, you can find the second point where I have marked 2 parts, like on the top and the bottom. So you have to write both of them in 1 point only. The crusades paved the way for increased trade contacts between Asia and Europe. Thus an increased interest in learning, travel and the spread of new ideas paved the way for the Renaissance in Europe. That you need to write in E4. And coming to the last question, that is E5. So write 2 points to show that monasteries played an important role in medieval Europe. This you have to show with the help of 2 points which you will get in page number 14, where the monastery and their impacts is written. So there I have underlined 2 points, that the first is monastery were centers from which Christianity spread to other religion. And the second point is monastery served people. They were guided by the motto service to society. Where what happened? The monks grew herbs in the monastery gardens and used to treat people who were sick. So children, we have come to an end to the question answers discussion. Many more questions that are from internal that will be given in the revision part. All the two chapters which we have done, we will be revising them, and in that revision all the internal questions also can be given to you to solve. Till then, you go thoroughly with the chapter, and these question answers you have to write along with the questions in your history notebook. And history notebook, children, remember, will be single rule notebook, single line rule notebook, no practical, only single line rule notebook will work.